The Pali word for meditation, bhavana, means to develop. We're trying to develop good qualities in the mind. So even though we're focused on the breath, it's the impact on the mind that we're interested in. Getting the mind more steady, getting the mind more resilient, getting the mind clearer. Because the mind has to be clear and resilient if it's going to see things. If we lack resilience, we come across something negative and we want to run away or push it away. We don't have the time or energy or even the inclination to want to look into it, to understand it. But the only way to get past things is to understand them. This is why the Buddha taught Rahula, even before he taught him breath meditations, make your mind like earth. People can throw disgusting things in the earth and the earth doesn't shrink away. The same with the other elements. Fire burns disgusting things, but the fire isn't disgusted. It just does its thing. In the same way, you have to accept the ups and downs of the world as normal, and then from there you can learn how to understand them. So this is the principle of non-reactivity. It's basically a teaching in patience and equanimity. Mindfulness is something else. Mindfulness is keeping things in mind. But patience and equanimity are good virtues in the path. Because at the very least, they enable you to put up with things you ordinarily couldn't put up with, and they also enable you to see things you otherwise wouldn't see. That's where it gets really important. But it doesn't mean you just sit there and do nothing. Based on patience and equanimity, then you start working on the breath. You can do all kinds of things with the breathing. Breathe long, breathe short, fast, slow, heavy, light, to see what works. And because you're observer is more steady, you're going to see things you wouldn't see otherwise. So make sure everything is based on patience and equanimity, and then do your exploration, do your playing around with the breath, experimenting with the breath. And that way you learn things about not only the breath, but also the mind. But make sure the foundation is solid. Otherwise, it's like putting scientific equipment, which is very sensitive, but placing it on a table that wobbles. Unless you're measuring the wobbling of the table, if you're trying to measure something else, then it's really bad, because you don't know what the thing you're measuring or the table or what is causing the equipment to have its reactions. But if the equipment is set on a table that's really solid, okay, then you can trust the data to come out. The same way with the things you observe in the meditation. If it's based on patience and equanimity, it's a lot more trustworthy. The experiments you do are more and more likely to show you real issues in the mind and the real solutions to those issues. So keep this foundation strong.